Hi everybody, in this class we are going to discuss about the organelle known as plastids, organelle that is plastids, and the next organelle will be vacuole. Next organelle will be vacuoles. So first organelle is plastids. Okay, plastids, these organelles are only found in plants. They are found in plants. Don't get confused about the chloroplast and plastid. Chloroplast we may find in some photosynthetic microbes or like algae, but plastids only it is found in plants. Okay, for the first time it was discovered by Ernest Haeckel. For the first time it was discovered by the scientist Ernest Haeckel, and a proper definition was given to the plastic by Schipper. Proper definition to the plastid was given by Schipper. First is it was discovered by Ernest Haeckel, and the definition, proper definition, was given by Schipper. Okay, Schipper. So plastid, it is found only in plants. And plastids are of two types. First one, chromoplast. Plast means what? Plastic. Chromo means what? Color. So, colored plastids are known as chromoplasts. First one is chromoplasts, and the second one is leucoplasts. Plasts means what? Plastids. Here leuco means what? Colorless or white. Okay, plasts means plastid. So these are the two types of plastids. Chromoplasts, colored plastids. Leucoplasts, colorless or white plastids. Okay, in chromoplasts we find chloroplast. The chlorophyll containing plastid we find it in chromoplast. Okay, so chromoplasts, they contain what? Chlorophyll containing plastid known as chloroplasts. Okay, does it is leucoplast or chromoplast? Chromoplast. Okay, so in chromoplast we find chloroplast. Chloro means what? Simple. Chlorophyll. Chlorophyll containing plastid is known as chloroplast. Okay, the plastids that contain the green color pigment known as chlorophyll, they are known as chloroplasts. And these chloroplasts are very important for photosynthesis. These chloroplasts, they help the plant in photosynthesis. You might be very familiar with photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is done by the chlorophyll. Okay, chlorophyll. If the plastid contains chlorophyll, it is known as chloroplast. If the plastid contains chlorophyll. It is known as chloroplast. And without chlorophyll, there is no photosynthesis. There will be no photosynthesis. So chlorophyll plays a vital role in photosynthesis. Okay, I am going to draw a simple structure of chloroplast in order to understand better. Now we are going to learn the structure of chloroplast. Okay, the simple structure of chloroplast. Chloroplasts are what? The plastids containing chlorophyll. So this is the simple chloroplast. Okay, just like mitochondria, chloroplast also will have two membranes, the outer membrane and the inner membrane. The outer membrane and inner membrane. This is outer membrane. Outer membrane and this one inner membrane. Inner membrane. And this space is known as inner membrane, inner membrane space, inner membrane space. And this part, okay, the empty part, we call it as stroma. Okay, the fluid filled part, we call it as stroma. Okay, this stroma, they contain what? They contain DNA and ribosomes. They contain DNA and ribosomes. Now, ribosomes are the protein synthesizing machinery. They are the protein synthesizing machinery. And DNA, it has the information. So to undergo replication, they use protein and DNA. This chloroplast need not to follow the instruction of nucleus to produce their own replica. That's why chloroplast and mitochondria, they undergo self-replication. They don't follow the rules of nucleus. So stroma, they contain what? DNA and ribosomes. So next, the coin-like structures that are present in the stroma, are known as thylakoid. The coin-like structures that are present in the stroma are known as thylakoid. Okay. So these single coin-like structures, they are known as thylakoid, and this full setup is known as grana. Grana. So like this grana, this single one is known as grana, and like this grana, there will be many. For example, here we can see, and here they are not round in shape but like oval shape. So these grana, they are joined by intergrana. So this is intergranular. Intergranular. Okay. So these single coin-like structures, they are known as thylakoid, and this full setup is known as grana. And many granums together, 1, 2, and 3, they form what? They form what? Grana. Grana, plural. Granum, singular. Okay, granum is single. Many granum together, grana. Many granum together is grana. So here, photosynthesis takes place by the help of the grana, by the help of this grana. Okay, this also, we also call it as light dependent reaction. When photosynthesis undergoes by the help of grana or grana, we call it as light dependent reaction. If photosynthesis takes place in absence of grana, that means the stroma takes, this stroma will participate in photosynthesis, that we call it as light independent reaction. Light independent reaction. Okay, so which all organelles they contain their own genetic matter? Question comes like this. Which organelles they contain their own genetic matter? It is chloroplasts and mitochondria. Don't forget, these two organelles, they contain their own genetic material. They contain their own genetic material. Once again, plastids are of two types, chromoplasts and leukoplasts. In chromoplasts, we saw chloroplasts. They contain what? Chlorophyll. That's why chloroplasts. Okay. And along with chlorophyll, okay, the chloroplasts along with chlorophyll, they also contain some other pigments like yellow color pigment and orange color pigment. Yellow color pigment and orange color pigment. If they contain yellow color pigment, they are known as xanthophyll. If they contain yellow color pigment, they are known as xanthophyll. If they contain orange color pigment, they are known as carotene. Okay, now what is the function of leukoplast? Leukoplast, it stores starch, oil and protein. It stores starch, oil and protein granules. Okay, next organelle is vacuole. Vacuoles was first discovered by, Antony van Leeuwenhoek. Okay, what is vacuole? Vacuoles are storage sac. Okay, they store what? Solid content and liquid content. Okay, to understand better, let me draw here. think this is plant cell. Think this is plant cell and it is having what? Cell wall. Okay, cell wall. And this is what? Cytosol. This is cytosol. It contains what? Nucleus at one corner. It contains nucleus at one corner. Why at one corner? Because the vacuole makes the maximum volume of the plant cell. Okay, so vacuole is large in size in plant cell compared to animal cell. In animal cell they are smaller in size, but in plant cell they are larger in size. So this vacuole will, due to the presence of vacuole, the nucleus are present at the periphery region. Okay, so this vacuole makes 50 to 90% of total volume of the cell. Okay, 50 to 90% of the total volume of the cell. Now these vacuoles are made up of single membrane. They are made up of single membrane. We know that all eukaryotic organisms, they are having membrane bound organelles. So vacuole, they are single membrane. But chloroplast and mitochondria, they are having two membranes. Okay, so chloroplast is having single membrane and it acts as what? Storage sac. Okay, and it stores the important substances required for the plant. Important substances required for the plant. They are stored in the vacuole. Okay, they are stored in the vacuole. So vacuole forms 50 to 90% okay of total volume of the cell. Not only important substance, it also stores the waste substance, okay, of the plant in the vacuole. So there is nothing wrong to call it as garbage of the plant. Okay, so vacuole also stores waste substances. Okay, next, the vacuole also store the secondary metabolites of the plant. Secondary metabolites of the plants. Okay, now again, vacuole only helps the plants to give rigidity and turgidity. Rigidity means what? Strength. And turgidity. Now here you can see the vacuole forms turgor pressure. The vacuole gives what? Turgor pressure. See here, the vacuoles would exert pressure towards the cell wall. Okay, they exert pressure towards the cell wall. If there is aqueous or water content. If there is water content in the vacuole. So what they will accept? They will accept turgor pressure. Turgor pressure would generate what? Turgidity. Okay. Turgidity. If water is removed from the vacuole, what will happen? what will happen? This cell will form a plastid. Cell will form plastid. Okay. Whenever there is more temperature, we find plants, okay, forming what? Plastid. If more water is present, plants, they stand straight, having turgidity and rigidity. Okay. What it is? Vacuoles are storage sac. They store what? Important substances and even waste substances and secondary metabolites. Okay. Vacuole will accept what? Turgor pressure. Okay. Giving the cell turgidity and rigidity. If water content is removed from the vacuoles, they form what? Flaccid. Flaccid means, okay, without strength. Okay. So this was your last heading of your lesson. Okay, we are going to proceed with next lesson in next video. Thank you.